Thank you very much, guys. What a game. One that had a little bit of everything. Malcolm Brogdon getting some high fives from Victor Oladipo. Malcolm, what a game. Let's zero in on the final couple of possessions. First, you give up the lead. Coach Bjorkgren calls timeout, and you guys diagram a perfect play for Sabonis. What was that huddle like?
Coach is just motivating us to execute on the offensive end. He just told Domas, go get a bucket. And that's what he does. That's what he did right there. And then defensively, man, get a stop. We work on defense so much, and our defense has gotten so much better this year. So we did what we were good at still.
So they inbound the ball. You're kind of isolated on Jason Tatum. You have a pretty good idea of what he's going to do, but you know what he's capable of as well. Take me through what you were thinking in that possession.
You know he's pulling. You know he's getting, you know, that step back off that right leg to a shot. He's made a lot of those shots, a lot of those game winners. So trying to contest it. He's 6'8", really skilled, really talented. All you can do is contest it and try to make him uncomfortable.
For those watching at home, and I was watching actually on the set, it felt kind of like a playoff atmosphere. I know there were no fans, but how did it feel to you?
Man, it felt good in here. We miss our fans, but we created our own energy tonight, man. We're coming off a back-to-back. To beat a really good team like that on the second night, that's an accomplishment.
A final thought, 3-0 to start the Nate Bjorkgren era. How in sync is everybody right now, and how happy are you with this start?
I'm happy. I'm not delighted. We have a long way to go. We have a long season ahead of us, but we have a brilliant coach, man. Extremely smart. ATOs, I mean, you name it. Every part of the game, he's on it. So we're excited about where this team can end up.
Thanks, Malcolm. Enjoy this. You'll get to see the Celtics again on Tuesday.
Yep, thank you.